Hey, I'm Joey Little, outside sales here at Mountain Land Supply. Today we're going to talk to you a little bit about valves. There's a lot of valves and even more applications for those valves, so we're just going to do a few today, and then you can absorb it and you'll do a little bit more later. So buckle up and let's go. So we're going to start out today with PRVs, or pressure reducing valves. You're going to find PRVs in any residential application coming from the culinary water source at the city going into your house. They start from 1/4 inch and go all the way through 6 inch. So we're going to show you a couple of those today. Your most common sizes are going to be 3/4 inch and 1 inch. We stock them in two different brands, Wilkins and Watts. And they are coming set from the factory at 50 PSI. You can notice on every one of these, there's going to be an identification tag with the model number and their set pressures and operating range. All right, now that you know everything you need to know about PRVs, let's go check out some gate valves. So we're here at the gate valve section here in Mountain Land and Orem. In gate valves, they range from 1/4 inch all the way through 24 inch, but inside we stock them up to 4 inch. They come in sweat and threaded ends, and they have a gear reduced operator on them, so you have minimum water hammer. So this is called a gate valve because obviously the gate slides up and down in a channel inside the valve, and you want to make sure that it is shut completely off or opened all the way. No throttling is done with this valve. Also on the side, you can notice that it has its pressure rating in water, oil, or gas of 200 PSI, its size, and heat codes. The next things we're going to talk about are going to be check valves, spring checks, and swing checks. One of the first check valves that was ever manufactured was a swing check. Swing checks have a swinging baffle on the inside of them that will stop the flow of water from one source to another source. Years later, they updated the design and created a spring check, which has a spring to create the force to shut off the water down the stream. They come in threaded ends, sweat ends, or PEX ends. Okay, we're coming to a really exciting part of our tour. We're gonna go see the ball valves. Come along. This is our ball valve section. This has most of our brass ball valves, and most of them are made by Cambraco or Apollo. We stock them here in 1/4 inch through 6 inch. The main advantages to a ball valve would be that it's a 1/4 turn shutoff and you have a positive shutoff. It's a bubble tight seal, where a gate valve, you have some sort of leakage around the disc. The reason why it's called a ball valve is because there's a floating ball on the inside of the valve that creates the seal. It presses against the Teflon seat and makes a bubble tight seal. All right, now it's on to the most exciting part of our trip, the grand finale, the butterfly valves, the It's a Small World of Mountain Land. So here's a butterfly valve. This is a lug style butterfly valve because you put the lugs of a bolt into the flange of the valve. You operate it on a 1/4 turn, and it's called a butterfly because it looks like a butterfly's wing on the inside of the valve. No gaskets are needed in installation of this valve because the rubber seat protrudes outside the flange. One main advantage for a wafer style butterfly valve is it is inline serviceable. You can place it inside the line, and if the valve fails, you simply undo the bolts on either side of the flange, pull it out, and either repair or replace the valve. Here at Mountain Land, we sell thousands of valves a year, so know them and know them well, and you'll be better off.